action, I think. Info. We're using EnviroText Lite. We're using Nickel, right?
Yeah.
We're using Doc Martens iridescent nickel. Looks like this. We're using, what teal are we using? This one?
Yeah, I want to use that.
We're using new color. Neo Cake by Jacquard in number 585 turquoise. It's a super light body opaque pigment. I would call it a paste, but it's not really as thick as a paste. Super awesome color. Slight iridescence, but it's like not metallic, just like slightly iridescent. Huh?
It's about burn my cup.
I think we're gonna forego the brown.
You want to do random clear, right? Or
yeah.
All clear?
You do random clear. That looks like the Avengers sign.
More like anarchy.
Yeah, look at that. So, about the white. I'm going to mix some white.
And if you guys noticed, we try not to pick it up and tilt it because a lot of these tests that we do are for countertops. So you can't pick up a countertop and tilt it unless you have that separate and, or, you know, it's brought to you or whatever. But you can't do that, so. Why would you make a test piece to where you tilted it? You would never get that type of effect when you did the actual countertop.
We're also using rose gold by Design Master. I don't think our regular brand does rose. Restellium doesn't do rose, does it?
I don't think so. I haven't seen it.
When you use metallics, actually when you use any spray paint, but particularly with metallics, you need to make sure that you didn't seal it.
I did.
You did. You did?
Well, they're popping. And they're coming back. Did I just spray paint it?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
There's no way I did that. I totally did that with this.
I thought you did that just with that
No, because I remember I did the bottom too. How did that even look at that? So how are we gonna stop these fucking bubbles?
We're just gonna have to keep revisiting it like we did on that big round. Every so often we're gonna have to come back and pop them.
one that we've had it in before. No, I want it to be like... I love how you can see this white. Mm. That clear. Is there some heat in here? Like, you would think that the resin would fall into it.
It is.
And then fill it.
So we didn't seal it well enough, and now these little guys are popping up. The way to remedy it is, basically, we're gonna have to come back and hit it with a heat gun every so often.
That, and that is what I love. Goes over it. I like how to make these. Like, if you blow on it, you blow this way and it'll shove all the paint, and then you can bring it back and make that a hard edge. Mm. Should we roll it? Or just blow? Mm. I think the roll is gonna...
Clear.
Look at that. Hey.
Sorry.
I don't know if I want to put that rose gold in there. I think it's just too much for that. It's like it's sinking into it. Well, it seems like the bubbles are kind of backing down again.
I just think there needs to be somewhere in here to balance it.
Just do it. Just grab it and do it. Let's heat up some of this. I wish that
nickel
was.
Look how fun that looks.
Heat this nickel up. That rose gold just doesn't do anything for me. Like, and see, I'm doing what you can't do on a countertop.
What, you didn't tilt it?
I turned it so I can get to it.
So you're gonna get up and walk to the other side?
Well, you can't on a countertop. Like, if it's like towards the wall, I don't like the rose. It sinks though, that's for sure. When you mix it with the resin, I would love to put that in there and then run it.
I like little veins of it like that better than splotches. So interesting how like it like mountaintops.
It's still a good looking piece all the way around.
I wonder if spritzing it with alcohol would take away those.
These are great colors, I'm not a fan of the deep, you know. I think he'll like it. And this almost matches that really
yellow
weird
ball.
Yellow, yeah. It just doesn't look like the nickel that we used at your mom's.
Same jar.
I wonder why it looks so different.
I think because it's so compacted. Like it's not over a large area.
See, this is what we need. We need a small little heater.
Can you heat that?
I think you could do that with your hands. You're just gonna take all the resin off. Like that, baby. You did that really good with that's how Michelle wanted it. And if you guys didn't see the Baltimore video, it's right here. You guys wanna go check it out. We did some bathrooms for our friend Michelle in Baltimore.
And my friend. Up to you. Lama.
And Ma. The little girl with the bedroom of a princess. It's like the more you heat it, like the more you like have like hot air, the bubbles come.
It's because it's thinner and it goes through the cracks faster. See, I was thinking something like this for her base.
Yeah. That looks great. And that's with, yeah, she'll love that.
I wish it was a prettier day so I could get a prettier video, but it is horribly overcast, but I digress. It ended up setting up okay, even though we had the bubble issue. and it was kind of colder. We are gonna have to do another top coat because this is what this little bubble here. What happens when it's not sealed all the way? We didn't end up sealing the bottom of it, which we will have to do before we do top coat. That way the resin doesn't drip through. And also the little tiles that we did out of the corner. I don't know if you can see them that well in that video, but this was all nickel and a burnt umber ink. Glitter comes from that nickel ink. It's turned out pretty well for a good test piece. The problem with doing test pieces this small is that you can't get a really good idea of how they'll look on a large scale, you know? Love. There it is. How that turned out. And then the one that we just poured all the rest of the gold on looks like glass. Very interesting for sure. Anyways, that's how these turned out. Hope that you liked the video. We will be doing a countertop later today. The gold and, the white and gold marble one, if it's not too humid. We got everything prepped up yesterday, which I will show you a video for all of that as well. Thank you guys for tuning in. Bye-bye.